Hey, I'm Grump. I'm not so Grump. And we're the Game Grumps.
Hey, Aaron.
What?
Can I share something with you from earlier today?
What is it, Dan?
Well, I sent you a text early in the morning.
Yeah.
Because I have to go out of town for one weekend.
Yeah.
This month. And so I was like, I won't give specific dates, but I was like, do you have any preference whether I go this weekend or the next weekend?
Mm-hmm.
Your response at 9:30 in the morning. Motherfucking Jesse Eisenberg. Jesus Christ, fuck, dude. Motherfucking Facebook movie bullshit. Jesus, can you fucking believe this shit? Nope, nope, no punctuation.
You just made me die.
Oh. Random capitalizations. So I respond, I have no idea what we're talking about right now.
Yeah.
45 minutes pass. I get a text from you. Goddamn, created Facebook and fucking lawyers and shit, right? Fucking Winkle Boss twins, goddamn rowing the boat. Fuck yo shit, I can't even fucking believe this shit. Have you seen this shit? Fuck, I just watched this shit. Fuck Jesse Eisenberg, man. I respond, Aaron, you're scaring me. An hour passes. You respond, motherfucking Spider-Man, Spider-Man, you put in the time. Fuck, put in the time. Motherfucking build shit with his bare hands. Fucking best friend shit, Jesse Eisenberg. I'm very tired. I'm just like, no problem, man. I'll do most of the talking at the grump session today. Immediate, like, response. I'm talking like 5 seconds later. No, man, I'll just talk about the Facebook movie all day. Shit, man, you have to be so interested in the shit I have to say about the Facebook movie. Fuck, dude, I just watched it a year and a half ago. Fuck Jesse Eisenberg, man. He fucked over Spider-Man, crazy Winkle Boss twins rowing. Trent Reznor or did the soundtrack. Fuck this guy. Who invented Facebook? I don't like dying. I can't think of who the fuck invented Facebook. All I can think is the guy who played the guy who invented Facebook. Who the fuck invented Facebook? And then, in all capital letters, 2 hours later, Mark Zuckerberg.
Shows out there. Some talk about other shows. Some talk about games. We talk about bronies. This is the Brony Show. I am your host. We are at episode 363, which, if you put it backwards, is also 363.
Yay, palindrome!
Of course, we are now going to ban Toakoi from talking for 5 minutes. However, we are here to bring you the fun and silliness of the Brony community for this week. And of course, and I'm not here to do it alone. Let's go ahead and introduce our panelists. We, of course, have Deathlight Productions.
Hey.
Textallion.
Yay.
Suki of the Otaku Ascended.
You know what? No, not this week.
Alright, bye.
We now have myself. I shall go ahead and start singing a cappella for you for the next 2 hours. La Falsinari, I cannot sing more.
Okay, now I'm actually going to leave. Bye.
And now it's Toa's turn on the floor.
Hello.
And I just moved him to the lonely corner.
Perfect.
Nice try.
I know. Yes, obviously you can tell Toa is here because there's no way he would hide himself until before his introduction. However, we're not here to talk about Toa and his constant interruptus. No, we are here to talk about the Brony community for this week. And it has been a relatively quiet week, unfortunately. I have a figure that it's probably due to the fact that right now we are in the cusp of the end of September. So we are just going to have to wait a couple more weeks when we can wake people up. Because September will end. But of course, that means...
The reason for that is because of Earth, Wind, and Fire, do you remember?
No.
No.
Yes.
No, it's too late for that.
We're talking about Green Day. Leave us alone.
Our reference is still fresh and could be used. Yours was outdated by 2 days. Any case. But yeah, best guess is September is probably just everybody is trying to get into the swing of school, swing of college, and they're just trying to get their breathing down before Hollywood comes and runs them over. Before Halloween comes and runs them over, then Thanksgiving fattens them up, and then Christmas strips us of all of our money. But of course, we are still going to talk about what we can find, and we got plenty to talk about. So let's go ahead and jump into this. We're going to actually jump right off into a big, important topic off the bat concerning the Brony Show here. Mainly the big thing is what we're doing in regards to the Equestria Girl shorts. Now, we have been showing them a little bit here and there, and for the most part, we were doing perfectly fine. We didn't have a problem as long as we waited until YouTube brought them up, and we showed them off of Hasbro's official YouTube. No problem. For some reason, the last couple of episodes, our video segment right now is completely unavailable. If you take a look, you can see that it is currently blocked worldwide. We are working to get this edited. However, it looks like Hasbro actually... I'm not sure if they're manually doing this or if they just got a really overzealous bot all of a sudden, but we put them up, they're perfectly fine for a few days, and then suddenly they get blocked. It's really, really strange, especially since they claim the content and then immediately block it. Which, you know, fair enough. They can claim the content. It's their content. I'm not going to complain about that, but the blocking is kind of weird.
The blocking is weird. I think it might be a bot.
It might be a bot, but it's a really weird, overzealous one. I think it also might be in response to all of the leaks and stuff going on with the end of the season and the series.
Yeah.
So in response to this, we are still going to mention the Equestria Girls shorts a little bit, and we are going to eventually mention the specials, both the music festival one as well as the upcoming holiday special. However, we will probably not be actually showing any of this on the main show. However, in response, though, we do know that some people wait for us in order to see the little shorts or because they don't exactly know where to find it at times. So we are going to show them first off in the coffeehouse after party after show. So for those of you who are curious about the Equestria Girl shorts, we will still have links to it in our notes. But we will be showing them in the coffeehouse after party after the mainstream is off. If you also want to just watch it with a bunch of people.
This is because of... Again, we don't want our show to be shut down again.
No, it's just we don't want it. We don't want to deal with having to edit videos. We're not going to get shut down from this.
True enough. Also, Creature works hard enough. We don't need to overwork that boy.
Yeah.
Right. In any case, just in case some of you aren't going to be able to wait until the coffeehouse after party for this one, let's go ahead and show off one of the best things I've ever seen real fast. Of course, we got Skull Crusher Fluttershy.
Oh, you mean Metal Shy?
No, it's actually Skull. It's a Skull Crusher. They actually call themselves Crushers.
I am fine with that, but I'm still like, that is her metal.
This is probably the most metal thing ever. And I am really, really surprised people have not taken off on this more. They did take off on it quite a bit, just not more.
Give it time. I'm sure
give it
time,
will.
Second. Give it time. They yeah. will. They will. Because they will combine this with Flutterbat and
Well, I don't know about Flutterbat, but we already got a ponified version of the image, so I'm happy there.
See, we're trying to slowly get a rock band together. We got Rarity, and now we're getting Fluttershy.
All right. So that explains all the porn that looks like that.
Yeah,
there's the taking off part I was mentioning too.
Yep.
So in any case, yeah, we do have a couple of specials that we will be showing at the end of the show today. So be sure to stay on and take a look at that. But that is just a bit of a heads up in regards to Equestria Girls. Pretty much kind of what we've relegated to in regards to episodes and specials and things like that. It just, we're not going to be able to actually show them anymore and talk about them, at least for the time being. Maybe we'll be able to do it in the future, far future, when Hasbro just doesn't give a hoot anymore because they have a new generation. Well, for now, we will still talk about it. We will still do what we can.
We have over 200 episodes to further dissect if we really, really dry up.
All right. Now, I did want to pose another quick question here to everybody. Now, I'm honestly suspecting that it might just be because September is just a really slow month. However, I have been noticing that our content creation has kind of dwindled quite a bit to the point where I'm the only one actually making something.
If you're talking about the art, I'm still doing it. I've just been busy.
No, I know. I'm just wondering, should we keep doing this? The big thing that I was trying to accomplish with this was to encourage people to try to continue to make content, even if it's small or large things.
Well, also have to remember, like Ponyman 64, he did the fix, vaguely creepy, did art. People can do the art, it's just sometimes it's random enough that it's like, the hell I'm doing this?
Right. Now, can I actually finish my statement before you interrupt me?
I'm sorry.
All right. Okay. So, yeah, essentially, I'm going to try to keep this going a few more weeks at least. I do want to pose the question if maybe we should retire the challenge of the week. Especially if it's not exactly encouraging people to jump in and try to do stuff. I'm still going to post content creation whenever we get it. I always love it when people make stuff for the show or for themselves, and I always want to encourage it. But, you know, maybe the challenge is a little too much. Maybe we're doing it too often, you know, maybe once a week is a little too much. Maybe it's just September is a bad month for this, and I'm just being a little discouraged because September is also emotionally draining for me. I don't know. It's kind of the question I'm posing to everybody out there. If you want to give me your thoughts, feel free to post it in Discord, post it in the chat here. I am keeping an eye on it. Vaguely, I'm not exactly sure what he's talking about when he says I missed it.
I think he said he missed the challenge window, like... Could be that, or it could be something else, because, as I said, I'm still...
Oh, he's talking to Glass. Oh, Glass missed it. Okay, fair enough.
My bad.
Yeah. Alright, well, in any case, that's just something I wanted to pose out for a thought a little bit here. We'll be coming back to this art in a moment, in a little bit later, obviously. But I think that's enough of my soapbox here for the Brony Show itself. Other than in a month or so, in about a month, I am going to be going to Ponyville Ciderfest, and I am actually going to be rooming with Winchester, and we have hopes that we are also going to get Winchester. Also, is bringing somebody else here.
It might be Owen Shirt Guy.
No,
Losses.
No. Steel Quartz. He's going to bring in Steel Quartz.
Yeah, Steel.
And we are also looking into the possibility of getting Crimson in with us as well. So, yeah, we might actually have a big group get together for that. So, something to look forward to there. And otherwise, I do have some things going on that I wish I could jump onto my soapbox and talk about, but until things are completely finalized, let's just say there are exciting things going on for me. Me personally, I don't think they'll affect the show in general, but we'll have to wait and see. But that's enough of me. That's enough of me talking about myself. Let's go ahead and let everybody else get their moment on the soapbox. So, guys, soapbox. Or let's... What's up, bronies?
Uh-huh. There you go. Smooth.
All right. Well, let's see. Saturday was the worst day I had in a bit. Slept in, had to deal with the clogged sink, and the Coke machine at work failed. So, yeah, my Saturday was a lot of fun. Anybody else have something better than that?
Well, I got my S10 home over the weekend, gave it a full detail and service, which is always nice.
Yeah, that's cool.
And that pretty much consumed my whole weekend.
Suki, how was your wrestling thing?
And today I got my shoulder, I got my elbow bashed by a car and my hand slammed by the same car too from the hood.
Ouch, that must have hurt, Suki. Deathlight though, that does sound terrible, man. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I thought you were done. My fault.
Nah.
Man, getting bashed didn't hurt. It's hitting my elbow is what hurt.
Oh, well. Alright, anybody else have any other What's Up Brony that I want to throw out there? Alright.
I did. It's right.
It's voluntary, man. Alright, we're going to go ahead and get into this then. Let's get into the news. Starting off with Discovery Family actually set up an Instagram with several villain Q&As going on. Of course, they are currently spoiler-free if you have kept up with what has been going on so far in the U.S. releases. So, in regards to that, we're going to go ahead. We also found out that people put the webums of this on the Derpy Boru. So we're going to have a little fun. It's going to start off with a Grogar one here real fast. Not Grogar, Tirek. And we should probably unmute him. There we go. And this is actually on Instagram, so you can actually watch it on Instagram.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years? I would love to open my own yoga studio. No one knows this about me, but when I'm not trying to conquer Equestria, I love to help others find their inner peace. Ouch.
Okay, so apparently Tirek likes yoga.
Tirek, where do you see yourself in...
Oh, no, stop that. Okay, here's another Q&A for giggles. These are all really short. They're just a few seconds.
Tirek, who do you look up to?
It's Lord Tirek for you.
It's Lord Tirek, damn you.
Actually, I have a great deal of respect for The Rock. He's strong.
Okay, yeah. You know, I'm not going to lie. This is the most amazing meta dumbass thing I've ever seen. This image alone, I could keep it right here forever, and this is all I need.
Second, it's even funnier that I think, what if this was done in glove and boot style?
I'm handsome just like me, and he can sure rock.
Oh, you know, that's the exact same rock in it that they use.
And, of course, we got Tirek with a fanny pack.
Hey, when you don't got pockets and you need to hold something, fanny pack.
Only the best will do.
And we also have one with Grogar. So, yes people have been asking for more information about Grogar. Here we go.
Of course it is I, the greatest, most powerful sorcerer the world has ever seen. But now that you bring it up, I've always been a little jealous of Penn and Teller.
Penn and Teller. I gotta admit, that was glorious right there.
Hard to find a reliable sidekick.
I do love Penn and Teller, though. Especially when they did their bullshit series way back when. That was the best show ever.
Also, they are
someone who could be trusted. You don't know how hard it is to find good help these days.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a favorite Instagram selfie?
Defeating the ponies is an all-consuming job, so I don't get to upload as much as I'd like to.
And I hear Blink in the background.
Took some time off to...
We always have Blink in the background, but maybe I should shut the door a little bit here. But yeah, these selfies are just
traveled
stupid and hilarious.
And captured a few marvelous images.
Okay, we've all seen that image of someone trying to hold up the tower.
I know, but that's a joke.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I want to see if somebody actually makes this shirt.
Somebody will.
Ponies have ponies. Oh.
All right. And now with that, I'm sure that we're going to get blocked once again by Hasbro. Because I can't help myself. But yeah, that is what they have been doing to promote the series finale a little bit on Instagram. There's probably going to be more. That's just what we have at the moment. Especially since we haven't heard from Chrissy or from that weird little thing that keeps popping up everywhere.
You mean the glow of Co's?
Nah. No, I
don't know. Nah, she has to have a better name than that.
No, we're going to talk about the bell. What? I have no idea. Yeah. All right, so let's go ahead and go a little bit into the mobile territory. And I mean a little bit because they recently did the Dark Waters MLP comic event. And it's already over. It literally lasted 3 days over the weekend. So this is to do with the comic series where the ponies got infected with Dark Water, which apparently made the worst parts of their attributes come out. It was more interesting because you basically had Pinkie Pie dressed up like the freaking Joker. You had Twilight doing the Riddler thing of absorbing people's brains. And Applejack trying to become a business mogul. Of course, with everybody else, I don't know too much. I didn't read the full comic series yet, and I really need to.
Already got a little bit of the Phantom of the Opera.
Well, obviously, Dash with a mask.
Dash was just a speed demon, and Fluttershy turned into... you know that scene in Shrek where Snow White calls in all the animals?
Nope. Go ahead. We're going to move on.
Yeah.
But
I'm just telling you, that's what happened.
I don't know why. As soon as you said Blackwater, my mind immediately went to the horror movie Blackwater.
Oh, mine went to the Pirates of Darkwater.
You know what? Let's go ahead and get a second opinion from somebody who follows this quite religiously, and I'm pretty sure has a very strong thought on this. Hi, CMC.
This event is like the others of the 3-day weekend type. It's boring now. Really, we want another Twilight lookalike rather than someone else? Great. Thanks, game.
But hey, this Twilight has red eyes.
Yes.
And then we can give her clear eyes.
How many doppelgangers of Twilight do we have running around?
I don't know, but I'm waiting.
Easy to get compared to all of the other main six.
It's
hard to get a doppelganger of Applejack.
Okay, I can't argue that, actually.
Nicer to have this fight that happened to be the other way around, such we would have gotten a rarity.
Fair enough. I'm just hoping that we get enough copycat Twilight Sparkles that there's actually six of them running around Cantrell at the same time I have six changelings.
They're all going to be in Ponyville.
I know. I can dream, though, can I?
Someday
my equestrian fantasy will come. But speaking of comics, let's go ahead and actually talk about the comics. The latest issue, 82, recently released. Of course, it's funny because the comic covers actually, two of them tell a story unintentionally. Of course, the first one, let's just say that the internet probably has corrupted quite a number of us and it doesn't look right in any way, shape, or form. Of course, the second...
I see no corruption here.
The second one, of course, is a lot more innocent, in a way.
Yeah, we're clearly talking about the third one.
The third one's pretty cool, though. I like that. The third one basically just looked like Twilight Sparkle looking a little badass while she's getting dressed up. Actually, I gotta admit that if you had five ponies literally swarming you and trying to clothe you, and you managed to keep an awesome look, you already win right there. You just
also
win.
Also, I honestly think that was a scene in, like, season one, because I don't see any wings on her.
What?
There's very little of her showing, though.
True. I just broke second. I'm happy.
I'm going to mute Toa for a moment just so I can actually explain this in full before he interrupts me. It can be considered the season one because the outfit she is wearing is the star dress outfit that she wore to the Grand Galloping Gala. That is all. I'm going to unmute Toa now so we can go ahead and talk about the comic itself. The comic itself dealt with Rarity having to train Cerberus because everybody else had a convenient excuse not to. And, of course, it ends up with her basically screaming at the dog, finding a way to come to terms. The CMC help out a little bit. But we also see Rarity being dragged along by the enormous pooch. So it's an okay issue. We will probably talk about it in full sometime in the later future. But that's just a quick synopsis. I do recommend checking it out, though. It is still quite a lot of fun. The art style is really good. And it's also fun just to see all the different facial expressions and motion that they put into the comic. Now, going ahead and moving on, the latest issue has been announced, issue 85, dealing with Applejack helping Apple Bloom learning about the meaning of courage with a story. And the fun thing about this is I believe there is the possibility of one of the comic covers actually being a pixelated comic cover like we are seeing here. Granted, I don't know if this is actually a preview of the comic cover or just another image altogether. I would love for this to be a comic cover because it's freaking awesome. But for the moment, all we have is a brief synopsis of the story. But yeah, I am with DM12 on 82. Funny story problems that kind of rubbed in a weird way, but we'll do a deeper analysis sometime in the future. Now let's go on to Media DHX, because it is no longer Media DHX. They have renamed themselves and everything around them to Wild Brain. With the current corporate jargon, rebranding as Wild Brain embraces our commitment to creativity, imagination, and innovation, and our 360-degree approach to brand management. For many years, our Wild Brain group has been at the leading edge of the digital media business as that landscape continues to rapidly evolve. Now is the time to unify all the parts of our company under both the name and entrepreneurial culture that Wild Brain represents. And this may be the last we ever talk about this, to be honest.
Yeah, wow.
Sounds like a wild ride.
All I'm going to say is, man, I deal in corporate jargon all day, and that made no sense to me.
Yeah, it hurt my head. All I could tell from this is the Hub is now dead. Media Day Checks is now dead. Everything that's been associated with Generation 4 is dying, other than Generation 4 itself. Go figure.
I think it's just because they didn't find DHX Media to be roll off the tongue.
Well, I'd imagine that easily, yeah. Wild Brain, but yeah. What we'll see coming from them in the future, who knows, but that is currently where that is sitting at. Let's go ahead and talk about other interesting things. Ember's apparently a guy. In Greece.
And here's the thing.
Here's the thing. We are going to let this speak for itself. So yeah. So I don't know what to make of this. Bigley's right. He sounds round and hairy. That's
yes, he does. I want to see that magnificent beard now.
Okay, tell MC G4 itself. The series is ending. The fandom is not going to die.
Mm-hmm.
Blah. Oh God! Oh God! That is going to be horrible. DM12 is talking about what it's going to be horrible when they get to the episode with the egg laying and Felicia has to ask her how they laid the eggs.
Hold on.
It said just in season 7, so this might be, as some say, an adaptation on Twilight's part and the having fun or flub.
Let us have our moment. Let us have our silliness, man.
You're ruining the... You threw off our groove.
I'm sorry, but you threw off the Brony.
I threw off the show's groove. Whee!
He's in the lonely corner. No, Animal Jam has added the main six. I have no idea what this game is. I have no idea what's going on with this. We basically have horses that are obviously knockoffs of the main six, and apparently you can change into them. They're called Arabian horses, by the way.
Oh, so the reason we have Saddle Arabians in the show.
But yeah, essentially you get to take on an animal form and do various things. If anybody else wants to actually check it out and give a brief idea, feel free to. I have a feeling you're going to have to pay for this, so I'm not going to bother.
And plus, it looks like a kid's game anyway.
It is a kid's game.
Yeah, it is very childlike.
Alright, now here's a fun thing. New Friendship is Magic story set figures have appeared. However, they are Asia exclusive. And for the reason... it's because a blind bag scaled angel bunny is packaged with a Fluttershy.
What?
This is the only reason these exist. And they only exist in Asia. So
people, bring them over here.
Yes, we want to have an angel bunny as part of my figure collection. It must be done. And maybe another one for Coldust.
Wait, it's the only reason it's because of angel bunny? So you cut out for me, or I cut out on you?
I don't think I cut out on anybody else, but yes, it is only because of Angel Bunny, nothing else.
I have to look and see if this was the thing we had here, because I swear I saw that at Walmart once.
Take a look at Angel Bunny, it might have changed. But while you're looking around Walmart, you can go to Target and get the Cutie Mark Crew Mystery Macaroon. Macaroon, like. I don't know how you say it.
Macaroon.
It is macaroon?
I believe macaroon. If I have not, then I have heard it wrong.
Well, they might have misspelled it here in the... macaroon, I would imagine a double O, right? Wouldn't it?
It's clearly pronounced macaron.
Macaron.
I don't know how to spell it.
Hey, macaroni. Hey, macaroni. Whatever. Moving on.
Yeah.
So, if you are interested in collecting the minifigures, as I am, they have a set of 12 based off of a delicious cookie pastry, which we are not going to try to pronounce again, for the love of God, but has some pony... Yeah.
I thought those were actual macaroons.
I know. It actually colors them quite well, doesn't it?
Yeah, that disappoints me greatly.
But yeah, if you actually want to have the color-coded cookies and ponies, sea ponies, and equestria girls sitting in them too, you now can buy this big 12-pack over at your local Target. I actually plan on doing so, along with catching up with a bunch of other things, because I'm still behind on at least an entire set that's out in the U.S. right now. Macaroni and cheese. Ooh, that's hilarious. And finally, for the last little bit of news here, let's go to our favorite news. Our favorite little thing to come out when it comes out. TeePublic is currently doing another 30% off sale and making t-shirts $13. Of course, we always bring them up because they always have the most interesting pony shirts whenever we take a look here. Starting off with this. I mean it is a pony. The others look actually pretty normal compared, but Twilight looks like her head is a Lego head. Am I the only one that's seeing this?
No, I see the shape, but I'm saying it's just because they didn't put the ears out far enough. But you know what I mean. If you were to draw the line from the top of the ears to the Lego part, you could totally see the ears.
Alright.
Part of it is generally when people draw ponies looking straight at you, they puff up the cheeks a little bit more.
Sure enough, yeah. And they also got a bunch of Equestria Girl shirts. I'm just going to go ahead and post the Sunset Shimmer, because honestly, this looks like the best out of all of them. But everybody has their favorite.
Remember, it's your opinion, and it doesn't matter.
Of course, if you follow some of the content creators out there, Brony Warbuck is also in TeePublic.
He does a lot of good stuff.
Yeah, I think this is a little bit of a callback to WoW and the recent vanilla update for that.
Mm-hmm.
Gore, we also have a cowgirl pear butter.
Cute.
Alright, and I'm not sure how to make... Well, we got Rainbow Dash, deal with it.
Of course.
Nice and classic. Always a classic.
Mm-hmm.
Good old Starlight Glimmer with a lot of Star Glimmers behind her. For those of you who like Starlight Glimmer.
We know of a few people.
And I'm just going to let this shirt speak for itself because I can't.
Okay, first, Thorax would totally be into this. Phalanx would have a look on his face like, why did you drag me into this?
Their eyes.
Again, why? I see Thorax as that. Phalanx, not so much.
I don't see Thorax as that at all.
No. Just because you can change into something doesn't mean it's a good idea, kids.
Yep. And just for, because we have to add something stupid, My Little Shrek.
I don't see anything wrong with that.
No, nothing wrong with that.
And everything else I'm seeing here, we've already shown off at some point. So here's a pathetic Princess Luna, because this is just too awesome not to have.
Pathetic.
Ooh, and with the goose as well.
And also... Yeah. There's also a bunch of pony t-shirts with inspirational quotes. Believe in yourself, stay loyal, stay kind. Pinkie Pie. But yeah, not much else in the way of TeePublic t-shirts, so we'll go ahead and move off of that. And let's go on to the fan submissions and suggestions. Of course, we talk about content creation and other fun things. The challenge of the week was ponies in a library. So I admit I didn't have a lot of time to draw this, so I managed to just throw this together within a 40-minute time frame before the Flagstop took over my life. You know who you are, Flagstop. And of course, along with this, we also had the Protest Initiative Challenge. Protest Initiative Challenge.
Hold on. I can't summon Cole. I can only do CMC, and that's finicky at the best of times.
Coldust.
Well, CMC, do you want to take spot for Coldust? Hello?
What? They're all dead.
Blah, I could go try and throw a knife at him.
Okay. Alright, while he's doing that...
Hit him in the hat.
Oh, now I see where I kind of goofed up on the chair here a little bit. All right. Well, anyway. So, yeah. The challenge was ponies in the library. I do have Circuit here. He is sitting in the library just enjoying a book. I could have done the book a little bit better. However, I also wanted to make sure I could get the title in there.
Ooh. I want to see. Ooh, you got My Pretty Pony in there.
Yes,
right,
there was also the Protest Initiative Challenge of putting in a My Pretty Pony, so I managed to sketch a My Pretty Pony from the figure that was supplied, and I also put on Cold Dust's trademark hat on it, or attempted to.
So you basically
have a My
very
Pony Cold Dust.
You very nearly, if you change the, like, if you give it, like, the appropriate colors, you almost have... Generation 1's My Little Pony. In Generation 1, they had a pony figure that was part of the Big Brother Ponies line,
right.
Which his name is Steamer, and he's a railway conductor, and he's got a little conductor's hat. So you very nearly made Steamer, which, by the way, if anyone wants to find a figure of Steamer with his hat and send it to me, I'm okay with that. That's a thing that I wouldn't mind.
Alright, and Glassport. Actually, Glassport, you ask, what library has a chair like this? I actually know some public libraries in my area that have chairs like this. They are big, cushy chairs. They're actually really nice.
Our public library, they have like this giant couch there, like very soft and stuff like that, and they got chairs and stuff like that too.
And I'm also kind of excited because they're rebuilding a library, which is literally within walking distance of my house. We're talking a 5-minute walking distance. And after the rebuild, they may have some really awesome furniture in there too.
Sweet. I need to stop by a local library more because it's literally just around the block from me. And I also recently redid my library card. So, yeah. And they actually have some railroad books that I don't have with information on railroads that I would love to know more about.
Cole, I just looked up people selling Steema. They also sell the hat. And the cheapest I have found for the hat is just under $29. And Steam is over $29, so
that's why he said somebody send it to him. He doesn't want to pay a penny.
Yeah.
I actually honestly I have been tempted to buy it on eBay in the past. It's just right now it's like maybe later.
You'll probably want to do it before November when they bring out the toys we grew up with.
No, because yeah, they won't do the Big Brother ponies once. They won't do the Big Brother ponies once.
Oh, they will
no
mention that.
Those.
And
all right, if you want to play that, if you want to play that card,
it's one of those really obscure ones that like parts of it because like they've got like a bunch of derivatives of the My Little Ponies from the first from like you know the first generation because they not only had like the My Little Pony bunch, they also had like the So Soft My Little Pony bunch where they had that fluff on them. And then there was, like, a bunch of other ones which I can't be fucked to remember. I think they had one that cried, too. So, yeah.
Also, a neat little fact that I learned. Apparently, the My Little Pony brand originally did last 10 years. So, we're actually neck and neck for whenever the last time it was around this long.
Well, when it comes to the series, where we well blew that out of the water because this is the longest lasting series of My Little Pony so far. And I would
have the most merchandise sold too out of all the series.
Yep, and the most fans.
Yeah.
That I can also believe.
And the most poor. I'm not going to go there.
No, right. we're not going to win that one. Digimon wins that one.
No, Pokemon.
We're anybody else but us.
No, we're in the top three.
Look away! Ignore us!
Yes, it's not us. It's Twilight Sparkle is totally not the most pornographied ever. Nope, nope, nope.
Alright, well, let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and get on to... unfortunately, we didn't have any entries this week. I'm
still working on mine, so I'll show it at the end of the show.
But yeah, I'm blaming just the beginning of September, and hopefully in the near future, everybody will start to jump in and start doing more. Remember, if you want to enter into this, it doesn't have to be just art. You can do writing. You can do poetry. You can do a haiku. You can write music. Yes.
Just a reminder, too, that Inktober is going to be coming up, too. So
yep.
Yeah.
That's all the more reason to do some more drawing. So
yeah, Inktober. It'd be great for Inktober, too, yeah.
Yeah. Circa, are you going to take part in Inktober this year?
Well, I'm already drawing, so I might as well give it a shot.
Yeah. Just get, like, some pit pens, and there you go. Ink away.
All right.
Yeah, I was just busy this weekend. That truck that I got was filthy when I first got it, so that's been me all day. And then I'm like, oh, I'll draw something when I get home, and then I dead-armed myself when I was at work.
And Circuit, sorry, I would have come up with a song this week, but I couldn't figure out anything that could go to the rhythm of "Fucked with an Anchor" by Aylstorm.
You know what? You know, I was actually waiting to see if somebody would point it out, but I can't believe nobody did. But there's a secret title on the book.
I wasn't really looking that closely at it. Sorry.
Nah.
How to get the something.
Okay, yeah.
How
I got...
to get the mayor.
Who is something in Equestria?
Okay, I gotta admit, I probably could have wrote that a little bit better. Okay.
My eyes are also really bad, so.
Okay, I'm gonna try it one more, or else it's just gonna get stupid here if I zoom it in further.
How to get near. Try to get near my D, who is Rabs of Equestria.
Okay, never mind. He's actually he's not being serious. Okay.
Yeah. I gave up on his seriousness like halfway through that.
You guys believe that I'm serious about anything ever?
Not all the time, but we give you some benefit of a doubt, and then we rapidly regret it.
No, that's normally
nerdy god or.
Just as a general word of reference, like if I'm not talking about trains, odds are I'm not being serious about what words are coming out of my mouth.
So, like now?
Yes.
You caught the message, good boy.
All right. So, any case, I'll go ahead and read it because I got in there that I probably could have done better on that, but I was quick to write. How to get the nerdy girl who is now ruler of Equestria.
Nice.
By the way, Circuit, just for future reference, when it comes to writing handwritten letters and stuff, if you shoot for like writing in all caps, it actually helps it come out a lot more clean. That's why in a lot of old comics, pretty much
it's all capitalized.
Yeah.
Gotta remember that one. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Oh, Glass 4 got it. It's not a light novel title. It's a self-help thing.
Or if he knows whenever I write text, it's also really big compared to almost everything else.
Alright.
Yeah.
But in any case, that is the only art submission we had. However, we did also have a truck submission from Deathlight, who got his latest $500 truck.
Yeah, well, when your daily driver blows up, you need to find something else.
I gotta admit, though, if I could get a truck like that for $500, I'd be good for
it. Go to auctions. You can buy vehicles for cheap. It's the shipping that'll kill you.
All right, Ponyman has Ponyman's got the quick write up here. Toakoi sat in a library. He appeared to be reading the book Moby Dick, crappy version. Inside the book was another book he was reading. Was the My Pretty Pony comic? No one must know.
My god! He got part of my thing, and I didn't even say anything.
So there you go. You have now won all the points this week, since Circuit can't have any points because he is the leader of the show, and that would be
a conflict of interest.
Deceitful.
What conflict of interest?
Deceit.
But let's go ahead and go on to the next week's challenge, which is my secret challenge. Next week's challenge. Secret second jobs. Sometimes people have to get an extra job in order to get a little extra money. Maybe it's because bills are coming in. Maybe they want to get a special something gift. Maybe they really want to get that new Nintendo Switch Atari 64 Turbo Platinum Pro. Whatever it is, sometimes people have that second job that they try to keep a little bit on the down low. Especially if it ends up either being mixing fruit smoothies or polishing a pole.
That's a nice way of saying. Never mind.
I just had to let the silence take it where it needed to.
Circuit, why would anybody have to hide a second job as a fireman?
You know, you're exactly right. I don't know why anybody would hide it, but maybe people do. Maybe they don't want maybe it's like tech support. You don't want people calling your house at all hours of the night. Hey, I got a fire. Could you come over and, you know, put it out for me, man? You know, I don't want to have to pay for an actual fireman.
I actually get called a lot for people asking me to work on their vehicles. It gets kind of annoying.
See, there's my point. So, secret second job. Somebody has a job. It could be another pony. It could be one of the show hosts. It could be your OC. It could be anything you want it to be. But they have a second job. Why do they have that second job? What is that second job? Only time will tell, and only you can tell us. And of course, we also have the Protest Initiative Challenge.
Protest Initiative Challenge is the maze corn. The corn maze? I'm not sure which it is. That's right, ponies in a corn maze, or maze corn, whatever it is.
I'm intrigued to see what side gigs we're all running.
So it's up to you guys, and up to you guys. And if you don't think I'm not talking about you, I am talking about you too. The protest is corn maze or maize corn.
Is it maize or is it corn? I can't tell.
It's a kettle corn maze. Should have known all along.
Ooh, that's a
all right, map. That's the thing. Without any links, I'll get posting.
By the way, if you're wondering, yes, this is heavily influenced by the fact that Quirpline is back. You guys should listen to Quirpline. It is so good. Seriously.
Oh, dear.
And to explain the image, it's basically, I decided to see the history of how the ponies evolved. We start with my pretty pony, then G2, split off into G3 and 3.5, hence why 3.5 is over on
the corn escape room right now.
I didn't get that far. Yeah, no. So where I was, where I left off, the maze corn was like, it was basically like a hallway, effectively.
Oh.
Which right. was just great. But yeah, no, you guys should listen to Quirpline. It is so good. They're on their second season. They're releasing episodes every week for like a season this time around. And it is by far my favorite thing that Loading Ready Run has ever produced. And deserves more support.
Check animated it. Or still only voice?
It's audio based, but like, just use your imagination. Come on, do some work.
Yeah, they were doing animations, but they found that was actually making the time for it to actually come out further and further away. So they already had it cut to the audio version. They just put that out.
Honestly, okay. I prefer it without animation just because it's so good as a radio show.
Okay. Like, all right.
Trust me, I've worked on a couple of radio shows. It is a lot of work.
It is a lot of work, but it's so worth it because, like, I don't know, there's just so much that you can do storytelling-wise that works so well with an audio base that would not work out to the same degree through any other medium. It is so good. Anyway, this isn't the podcast show. Right, what pony thing do you have next?
Well, actually, I was about to get to that. However, I just realized the restream chat is not showing. I have the window up and I see people are chatting, but it's not reflecting what people are chatting.
Refresh the page.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, I think it just kicked. I think it just kicked.
My thing.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it just had a moment. I'm sorry, everybody. I don't know. Maybe I missed something for a moment.
So, Cole, I may need spelling to figure out what I'm putting on the site header for the protest initiative.
Okay.
Okay, quickly.
Figure out which spellings of corn and... corn and maize and... maze.
All right, I think I got it. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on here. So
CMC have one B M A Z and the other one M.
I'm going to let Cole tell me. You go on.
Wait, there are different spellings of corn maze and maize corn. Yes.
Well,
yep.
There actually is, depending on what you're driving at.
I'm going to say M A I Z. C A R M.